Hi all, I am Marina Latini from Studio Storti, and today I want to present immigration, the migration of the municipality of Bari in Italy. Bari is a city in the southeast of Italy, and this migration involves about 2,000 users. And the migration started in last year in September, and this is a part of the digital agenda of the municipality of Bari. In particular, the goal of this migration is to we want to try to migrate about the 75% of the seats by the end of this year. It's not so difficult because from last year we have started a pilot project of about 100 seats from different departments of the municipality of Bari. So we have done a lot of tests. The particular aspect of this migration is that the migration is started as a way to save money and a way to respect the Italian laws. So this is not only the main aspect of immigration as we know from the migration protocol, the TDF migration protocol. They contact us after reading about the successful migration of the Umbria region in Italy, and after this migration they decided to adopt LibreOffice in their municipality and in their workflow. So this seems to be the main aspect for them, but it's important also because with this migration they want to cut the large numbers of Microsoft Office licenses, and we have estimated that after about the next 5 years they will save about 75,000 euros. So this is a large save of money. But we know that immigration isn't only a way to save money. In particular, we know that there are yes, the window is not so casual. In particular, with this migration, we try to review their workflow. We started to create the templates for their documents because they doesn't use a template or models. As always, they open the last document and reuse it for the next new document. So this is a way to introduce a new workflow in this particular municipality, but in general with all the city that decide to migrate from Microsoft Office to LibreOffice. So we worked also in interoperability because of they use a lot of different versions of Microsoft Office. So you can imagine that when you try to use a document from several versions of Microsoft Office, you can have a document that explode every time you try to make a little change to the content. So another aspect is related to the problem of Microsoft clear type fonts. They don't know that this particular kind of fonts are installed in the newer version of Microsoft Office, and that those particular fonts have a license and in Erla that can cause also a lot of legal problem for the municipality. Also for a municipality that decide to switch off the entirely Microsoft Office licenses and adopt LibreOffice. So during our work we try to collect a lot of information, in particular during the assessment process. In Studiosorti we follow the migration and training protocol of TDF. So the assessment, as you know, is a fundamental step of the migration protocol. And after this phase of analysis, we can obtain a real awareness of the problem, the lock-in originated by Microsoft Office or other proprietary software vendor. This is one of the real problem related to the user. The user need to be well informed. Usually, you know that the resistance to change is quite common in any kind of migration, and usually the user can be afraid. The user feels alone when he need to use software and in particular a new software. So usually the user isn't interested in migration or adoption of open source software. He only wants a tool that can permit to solve his work. This is the main goal of a user. So the resistance to change is one of the main problems related to the user. And the communication usually is the answer to all these kind of problems. With the communication, you can prevent the resistance to change. With communication, you also can fight the resistance to change. All the user needs to be involved in all the phases of the migration. And the communication is important not only for internal user, but also for external user that can works with or interact with the public administration. So the communication is one of the aspects that must be curated during the migration. And usually, when a user is in front of a new software,
he can search for a specific feature, or can propose an enhancement for the software. And this is the base of this particular migration. So during this pilot project, we have collected all this information, and we have organized the trainings for all these users. What kind of trainings? We follow the TDF program protocol, so we have organized two kinds of trainings. One dedicated to the technician, dedicated to the internal help desk. In particular, the municipality of Bari has about 10 persons dedicated to the first level support. So this particular trainings was were focused on deploy or FAQ and so on, while the trainings dedicated to the other user, the expert user of the municipality, was organized as for the TDF protocol, focused on writer, calc, impress, and draw. Draw was used in particular for creating graphics to be used in the presentation. And this second round of trainings was for about 20 persons. These particular users are the internal trainers for the all the other users of the municipality of Bari. And this is the second big problem related to technical aspect. In Italy, we have a lot of software houses that create their own software that sold to the public administration. And we have problems because often these software are old, or the software house is closed, or this software doesn't support the ODF file format. So we need to work hard for reach a good level of interoperability. For example, some software uses the RTF file format. Okay. I hate the RTF file format. I want to make a t-shirt 8 RTF. They use a kind of handmade doc file format and so on. So we have a lot of problems to interact with these software houses. And I hope that in this particular case, TDF can help us. We need to contact, we need to write directly to these software houses, and we need to write to them as a foundation, and not only as a municipality or an individual corporate that try to migrate from Microsoft Office to LibreOffice. So this can be an idea to simplify our works. And in particular, we need to work hard in communication and promotion of the importance of using open standard and open formats. This is one of the of the problem. The user create a file and click a button to save. He doesn't know if the file is in a standard format and so on. He don't take care. He want only to use a tool for doing his work. So the problem related to third-party software is not so. It's not so easy to solve, but we can try. We are doing a lot of work, and something is moving on. Some software houses now have migrated their software, and now they are using ODF file format. So we can change. We can obtain something from the software houses, but it's a long war, it's a long fight. And in the migration of this particular municipality, now we are ready to start with a massive deploy of the suite. In particular, they are using Active Directory and GPO policy. So we have created custom policy files or custom MSI plus MST transformation file for the deploy. They are using the LibreOffice still version, the vanilla version. And now they are happy to use a software that can do the same things of Microsoft Office. Now they are aware of the potentiality of LibreOffice. So December is arriving, and we are moving on to this important migration. Any questions? Any?
Two questions.
Okay.
First of all, how long did it take you to move in to Singapore?
Okay. It's not so simple. The software houses are
lobbying.
Okay, maybe.
Hello?
Okay. No. In some cases, they simply don't know that there are open format and open standards. So. We have tried to talk about ODF and so on. In other cases, they doesn't respond to an email, a call, and so on. It's not so simple.
Yeah, just to compliment, in the case of a software house that is connected with Microsoft formats. I had an experience that I called them to see if they can support ODF and make it easy for LibreOffice to connect to the application. And they returned to me to see who is going to pay for this change. Yeah, so they need a business case sometimes.
Sure.
To do that.
In Italy, we have a lot of laws that
request
the adoption of open standard and open formats. So. We can try to use these those laws to press these those software houses, but it's not so simple. This is a real problem. Someone don't respond to our email or they respond that they are using this software that it works and that it's not a problem for them.
For example, there is a little software house named Halley.
Halley.
Halley says that they use RPF.
It works. It's a standard, okay. It's an open standard.
They say that it's a standard.
It works.
And Halley manage many leading municipality in Italy, and it's a problem for us.
But I believe
yes.
That
it's a big problem.
The real problem is that, you know, in Italy, we don't have a central administration for our information technology. So every single municipality has to organize by itself. So there is no union in that. And that's a real problem, because if they were under a union, for example, they may say, well, all together, well, we need this feature. Also because they are the customer. So they may say as well, well, either you implement this function, this feature, or otherwise I won't sign the new agreement, the new contract. Okay? But they won't, because taking just similarity, just one municipality by a time, they won't care. Let's say Halle Informatica, they may have, let's say, 500 municipalities. If one of them doesn't renew the contract, who cares?
As in Italia, we think we prepare a document with the software house that manages their software with the office that.
Yeah. Well, I can tell you that this multitude of municipality, states, countries. Is everywhere in the world. For them, the most fragmented, the best, yes, because there are choices for everybody.
And the problem is that they can't realize that, because I was talking to a CEO manager in my town, and he said, what can we do? What can you do? You are the customer. You signed the contract and so on. Say, I will change my provider. Oh, it's impossible. It's so, nested. So
it depends on the situation. I had a big oil company that could do that, you know, but even with a big oil company, 100,000 seats, it was just one among many other big companies. So,
even in large scale, it's the same problem.
Scale, the same problem is occurring. Right.
I wish that happened. The fact is that we have loads now. Which we have real loads. They are the first one who
doesn't
attend.
Yes, 10 years ago.
We have a low.
Very
old.
Sorry.
But it's not a problem. That's a low, but.
Yeah, the first year, they make loads and they're the first who really doesn't follow them.
Okay.
Yes. So